Okay, so I've just taped the back of this screen so that the only open area is going to fit the same size as my stencil paper. So what I'm going to do next is I'm going to put the screen into the hinge clamps, get it in place, and it will stay there. It will stay fixed in place until we're finished printing this particular color. And I've made little holes and put a piece of masking tape to help stick this paper stencil onto the screen. The ink itself, the surface tension in the ink is going to hold the rest of it in place, but this is just a little help. So you press down there, a little bit of masking tape, and that's my stencil hanging on. One other little tip I'm going to show you is I'm taking a piece of mat board and I'm going to tape a piece under each corner, each outside corner of the screen, which is going to raise the screen up a little bit, and that's going to give me the right what I call bounce, because you want the mesh to be not flush with the surface. You want it to be sticking up a little bit. The next thing is to put in this clear poly for registration. My first print is going to be onto the clear, and then I'll be able to slide the paper underneath the clear and line it up. So I'm just kind of eyeballing it. Where it's going to land, that's good. It'll land in the right place. And then just a full strip of masking tape. I'm just going to trim this because this piece of plastic has to be able to flip out of the way, and it has to stay fixed for the whole time as well. All right, so now we're ready to print. I have my ink pre-mixed, and I'm going to put ink on the mesh at the top of the stencil, and I want to put it the width of the squeegee. So you don't want any sort of dry spots, so a little bit more. Screen printing lays down a very thin layer of ink, so a little bit goes a long way in terms of this volume here. And I'm not going to raise my screen yet, I'm just going to do the first print straight through, holding my squeegee at a sharp 45 degree angle and pulling towards me. My second stroke is away from me and I'm flooding the screen, which means putting ink into the open areas of the mesh. It worked out pretty well. My next one is going to be right onto the acetate right away. Once you start printing, you have to keep going. There, that one popped better. That's good. It released better. And I flood. So today I'm going to show you two kinds of registration. Both of them use an acetate method, but one of them is just with tabs that we tape down in the corners so that the card or stock that you're printing on is going to line up. And the acetate registration by itself, which is the one that I prefer, because when you use that way every time, you will have what we call perfect registration. So screen printing is the principle or the method is pretty much the same no matter what you're printing. You could be printing giant billboards or a bus shelter, you could be printing a t-shirt, or you could be printing cards like this. And it all works the same way. You have to have a mesh that has open areas and closed areas, and you pull it with a squeegee. The differences are basically the conditions. If you're printing on t-shirts, you want to have a different size of mesh, a different gauge, where it's got bigger holes. You want to have a sort of a soft surface rather than a hard surface like this for textiles. They're looking really good right now. It does take a while sometimes to get. Again, it's like priming the pump. You want to print and print and print, and then they start coming out good. So I have the first color printed. I've got my second color stencil on the screen ready to go. And now I'm going to mix my color for the second color. So I've taken a couple of the prints that were a bit flawed in the printing to use as a reference to mix my second color. But I just want to mix it a little bit because I don't know exactly what naphthol red medium is going to look like against that crust. And I'm also using this golden silkscreen medium, which says to start mixing 1:1 as a starting point. So I'm going to take some of this, which is relatively transparent, just on a little test here, before I mix it in the paper cup and see if that looks like red fruit. Well, it does. It looks like red currant, But if I wanted it to be strawberry rhubarb, I would probably have to adjust this a little bit. The thing to know about screen printing is that it lays down a very, very thin layer of ink. It's not like painting where it's thick and textured and impasto. So the color that you see here isn't necessarily going to be exactly the same. It's going to be thin. Okay, so almost ready to print the second color now. These are the registration marks from the first color, but I'm going to remove them because we have to set up a new registration, and I'm going to show you how quick and easy that is to do. The first print is going to be on newsprint. I'm using red. Spreading it along the front of the open area. And pressing down, 45 degree angle, and print, and flood. So that's your image. That's the image we're doing this time. Next, we're going to print it on the acetate. Pull, and flood. Take this artwork, put it underneath, and line it up as close as we can possibly get it. You just do this every time, and it's gonna work because this acetate is very stable. It's locked in. This takes a little bit longer with your hands, but not much. Okay, so we've got two colors printed. We've got our third stencil on the screen. The screen is in place. This is a different screen. It's a little bit smaller than the other one. It's a different stencil. It's the vinyl masky stencil. It's a little bit more dimensionally stable, better for the detail. So I'm going to use the same method of registration as I did for the second color and put my ink on the screen. And I'll flood the image. And then I'm going to print on the acetate. That's my first print. And then flood. Oops. What the acetate registration is really good for is if you make errors, or if your first colors aren't, like this color is way off. It's, you know, it's much further off. So this type of registration will fix it. This is raised up higher because it's a smaller area, so in order to have the mesh meet the surface, I have to press harder. You want to be sure to flood it because those little pores in the mesh will dry out really quickly if there's no wet ink inside them. That's the reason for the flood stroke. All right, so that's the last print of the day. Basic screen printing. If you need or want more information about this, anybody at any of the Opus stores should be able to help you. We've got lots of products, lots of technique, and a really great video. Thanks for watching.